Last week Thursday, I made those very proposal, strengthening the generals of office for them to have their own budget, to be totally independent with subpoena powers and investigative power, strengthening the integrity commission, remove it from the control of the government, again with their independent budget and with the ability to be able to investigate any and everybody. You know, the very proposal that we made, host meetings, at least one host meeting per month, strengthening the PAP, making sure that the government cannot control and frustrate the work of the Public Accounts Committee, that we want to be able to stream live all from host committee meetings so that every citizen can see what is going on in these host committees. We're talking about openness, transparency and accountability. So I'm happy that the union support the proposals that we made last week Thursday. These are solid proposals that we are going to present within the first 100 days of the new P.U.P. government, including campaign finance legislation.
Now, sir, interestingly, while the P.U.P. has made a call for general elections now, interestingly, the unions have not done so. Instead, they're saying otherwise, that all these things must be met before a general election is called. Anything to that?
This is where we disagree vehemently with the unions. If the UDP government has been unable to make these changes in 12 years, how can we expect them to do these changes in 6 months or 7 months or 8 months? And if they do it, it's going to be a hatchet job. So we need to do it with enough consultations. The idea is that we're going to present these bills and then have wide consultations with everybody from the unions to the private sector, to our social partners, the churches, everybody, so for us to be able to have laws that not only sound good, but also that it can work for the benefit of the people of this country.